Hey, professor, for my exam, I'm going to be talking about my musical autobiography and revamping it to how my musical past and my musical future have been changed and concerts in class that have affected that. I want to talk about how, to begin with, my musical past begins with my father. A lot of the things that I am interested in, the music that I'm interested in, is because of him. He used to listen to R&B and hip-hop, old R&B and hip-hop, as in 80s, 90s, 2000s. When I was younger, whenever I was in his car, the radio station would be turned to songs that would play classic soul or classic smooth R&B. And if it wasn't that, he would be singing rap in the house every day. And so a lot of the songs I listened to came from him. He even used to do these Christmas parties every year, and people would come to his Christmas parties. He would use the same list every single year, same playlist every year. And the playlist would consist of solely R&B and hip hop. And so at some point, people will stop coming for the music and start coming for the good times. But they had already associated that music with good time feelings. So I respect him for that, for being able to create a good vibes with just a set playlist of songs. And so to emulate that, I want to open a lounge business in my future. So my future will be forever intertwined with music. I won't be able to escape it if I wanted to. So similar to the Evergreen article and how they were able to alter Hindu songs and remix them for Bollywood, I want to do the same thing with kind of the playlist my dad used, R&B, hip-hop playlist, but I want to remix it and change it so that it will be suited towards my generation instead of his. But I still want to be able to create that same pristine culture that he had at his Christmas parties. To do that, I will definitely need to... certain parts of this class stuck out with me, specifically Martin Stokes' article talking about the different elements of ethnomusicology, and specifically the ethnicity, gender identity, and performance in place because I want to do a lounge, and so I feel that my music has to complement the lounge setting that I'm in. I feel like, as Martin Stokes said in his article, the place is where the social activity is made. And so that social atmosphere that I want to create for my lounge is going to be heavily impacted by the music that I choose. And so I have to make sure that both are good and are compatible so I can get the same pristine culture that my father had when he would throw his Christmas parties. I also want to look at gender identity because I feel that it will be important to show gender inclusivity. And especially now, it is 2021. Gender inclusivity is important. Equalization is important. I want to make sure that my lounge and the music that I promote shows that. And since I consider the lounge to be an extension of my musical encounters in the future, I want to emulate that as well as in gender neutral area, gender equal area. Finally, ethnicity. I will be running a lounge, so it will be hard to create a space where all ethnicities feel included because music is ethnically loaded to some and not to the other. And so that'll be a challenge that I will face, and that is why that was a very important part of this class for me. Finally, I think it's also important to, when considering a lounge, to look at participatory performances and presentational performances. I think they both will have their benefits, and so that was a part of the class that stuck out to me as a possible business idea in the future, thinking about what will yield the highest amount of people to my lounge and highest monetary yield, but also what will give the best vibes, if presentational or participatory performance, because I can see the benefits of both. I could have people dancing over here because it's participatory, but also they could be rocking with a singer for our presentational. So I really like that aspect of class because I really feel like that will be a good way for me to judge my lounge and also judge the feelings and vibes of others, because that is extremely important in the lounge industry as well. So that is how my musical future has been affected by my musical past, as well as key topics in this class. Thank you.